Tom Anderson of Yes.
Wow.
Actually, I'm not. I'm with the ARW now.
Wow. Wow. Hello, John.
How's it going?
It's exciting to welcome you to AC, first of all. And it's, around here, it's being described, and I am in full agreement, the definitive Yes lineup, ARW. Are on the road, and we are all excited here.
Well, we had our first show last night in Orlando, and it went down a storm. It was like unbelievable energy from the crowd, and we just played like crazy guys, and we had a great time.
Yeah, I mean, you're providing your own hurricane winds down here, right?
Absolutely.
Yesterday, in preparing to call you, I read a recent interview with Rick Wakeman. He said, quote, "He can't stop smiling. ARW is all smiles," end quote. Tell us about ARW.
Well, we're very happy people. We're very grateful. We're very thankful. We're really good musicians. We love playing our music. And we just want to have a good time. Celebration of Yes music.
You know, as a kid growing up in Lancashire, Northwest England, your musical influences were blues-rooted. Elvis, Everly Brothers, among others. Yet your early Yes successes seemed less bluesy, more progressive, symphonic. Were you trying to basically maybe separate from the Stones and Beatles back then?
I think that I was working with very talented musicians that would listen to my ideas. And I come up with some crazy ideas. Let's do the song by Paul Simon, America. But then let's throw in some music from Leonard Bernstein, you know, from West Side Story, and things like that. So that everything we did was just an adventure, musical adventure, because in all intents and purposes, music is for getting up and singing and going on stage. And the last thing I ever wanted to do was to have a hit record. I just wanted to create music that was great for stage. And then we started making albums, and of course, musicians come and go. Steve Howe joined, Rick Wakeman. These are great, talented people, and they're happy to listen to my crazy ideas. And that's why we got into long-form pieces of music like You and I and Close to the Edge. And the rest is kind of history in a way.
You know, aside from your early musical influences from American rhythm and blues, Rick Wakeman pointed to his close relationship with David Bowie as a mentor in studio work, writing, self-determination, and overall caring. Do you have a musical peer who has guided you through the years?
Well, my friend Vangelis, a Greek composer who is very famous for Chariots of Fire, the music for the movie, and of course the big hit record, and of course everybody that I ever listened to, from Frank Zappa to the Beatles, obviously, and the Beach Boys, and you know, early music. I was very into Nina Simone, who's one of the great songwriters of all time. So I had a great sort of schooling in music all the way through my career.
And you come from a musical family. Your parents were musical and were ballroom dancing champions. Any chance we will see John Anderson on a future Dancing with the Stars? You know, it's a big hit around these parts.
No, please, no.
Well, I know you're a painter and an artist, so maybe you go that way as well, beyond music.
Yes, I love painting. I've been painting last couple of months, a lot of painting, because I was getting ready for the show. Getting ready for rehearsing, and I thought, I'll do some painting just to relax, and I enjoyed that very much.
Now, I am a 40-plus year Yes fan. As a fan of your music since first hearing the Roundabout record, late 71 or 1972, I went out and saw the other Yes tour with Steve Howe this past summer. The music, of course, for the fans like myself, timeless, but are the players estranged at this point? Are you guys ever, do you ever get together or you know, plan a tour or whatever?
No, really. You know, Steve and Alan and Chris went their way when I never left the band, but they just wanted to tour more, and I was going to a couple of times. I wasn't too good, you know, life. You're never always healthy, and it really wasn't very nice of them, of course, but you forgive and forget, and all I'm interested in is performing Yes music. That's what they do. There's a lot of bands out there, like Yes Songs, a great band in Italy that play Yes music. These are kind of bands that love Yes music, and we should all, you know, enjoy the fact that we love playing it. And Yes music is forever for me.
Right, right on, for all of us. Now, your 2016 set list, I heard 90125, even Big Generator selections. I always loved Rhythm of Love.
We're doing that one. That's really wild.
Nice.
We did it last night, our first show. And you and I, On a Lonely Heart, Roundabout, Long Distance Run Around, Awaken, you name it, we're playing it.
And you also, I don't know, a lot of people know this, but you also had a pretty cool Christmas album out, Three Ships. As we get closer, November, December, are you going to be breaking out any of that material?
I don't think so, but I can always sing Jingle Bells.
Well, that's keeping in the season, I guess.
Yeah.
But anyway, the Borgata is going to be a time machine event for all of us, Rocktober the 28th. John, by the way, we share a birthday on the 25th.
Cool.
So you will have to send me a shout-out or something, all right?
I will. Happy birthday to you on the 25th, my man.
All right, you as well, John Anderson from Yes, and he's got his ARW, Anderson, Rabin, and Wakeman to the Borgata. We're going to give away some tickets right now. John, just want to thank you for spending some time with me and look forward to the show and have a great tour. And stay out of the hurricane there in South Florida. Good luck getting out of there.
Thanks so much. Take care now.
Take care, John.
Cheers.